Light of the world, you stepped down into darkness, opened my eyes, let me see. Beauty that made this heart adore you, hope of a life spent with you. So here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And today we celebrate the fourth Sunday of Easter, and it's the familiar and charming image of Jesus as the Good Shepherd. But the gospel, as always, has an interesting twist. But also, this is in the month of April, and April is Child Abuse Prevention Month, and so we have this candle lit in honor of that, to keep that intention alive in our hearts. So let us begin with a few moments of reflection and ask the Lord for the forgiveness that we might need. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. And therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King. O God, almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Amen, amen.
And let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said, "Leaders of the people and elders, if we are being examined today about a good deed done to a cripple, namely, by what means he was saved, then all of you and all the people of Israel should know that it was in the name of Jesus Christ, the Nazarene, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead. In his name, this man stands before you healed. He is the stone rejected by you, the builders, which has become the cornerstone. There is no salvation through anyone else, nor is there any other name under heaven given to the human race by which we are to be saved." The word of the Lord.
The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in man. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes. The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. I will give thanks to you, for you have answered me and have been my Savior. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. I will give thanks to you, for you have answered me and have been my Savior. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his kindness endures forever. The stone rejected by the builders has become the cornerstone.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet, so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. I am the good shepherd, says the Lord. I know my sheep, and mine know me. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. A good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. A hired man who is not a shepherd and whose sheep are not his own sees a wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away, and the wolf catches and scatters them. This is because he works for pay and has no concern for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know mine, and mine know me. Just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. These also I must lead, and they will hear my voice, and there will be one flock, one shepherd. This is why the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down on my own. I have power to lay it down and power to take it up again. This command I have received from my Father. The Gospel of the Lord.
On this Good Shepherd Sunday, we have this beautiful, charming image that has just captivated people's hearts down through the generations. For centuries, people have loved this image of Jesus as the Good Shepherd. Of course, that was a common image for people at that time, and ironically, it was a common image for me when I was growing up. I grew up in Thousand Oaks in Ventura County. It's a big city now, but when I was a kid, it was really a lot of fields, and it was a sheep grazing area. So I remember watching a lot of sheep when I was young, and I learned then, and the people knew in the gospel, that sheep are by nature extremely timid animals. They're afraid of everything. They huddle together. At the slightest little rustle of a bush, they'll run to the shepherd, and they look to the shepherd to be that bold, that strong, that courageous person who is unafraid of any wolf, unafraid of a lion, who is there to always have the best interests of the sheep at heart, to bring them good food and water, and to protect them. And so we have this beautiful image of Jesus saying, I am the good shepherd, follow me. But Jesus is asking us to follow him not as sheep. Jesus wants to follow him as shepherds ourselves. Jesus is inviting us to also be a shepherd, not to be a timid, frightened person, but to be a bold and courageous person who can live their faith in this kind of, you know, intimidating as it can be sometimes world as it is now. You know, you are almost for sure have some position of leadership in some area of your life, whether it's in your family, at work, maybe in school, in your neighborhood, even just amongst friends. You are in a position to be a leader. And Jesus invites everyone who is a Christian not to be a timid sheep, but to be a bold and courageous leader, to speak our faith whenever it is, and to never be frightened by the wolves that are out there. You know, for many months now in our country, we've had violent protests and intimidating tactics, cancel culture. It's ironic because violent people are protesting violence by using violence. Not much common sense there. And our voices must never be aligned with theirs. We are the kind of people who are not afraid to speak our faith. I'm glad we see that so much at St. Bruno. We have our youth and family ministry that has so many young people in it. We just finished our first Holy Communion with so many young people receiving First Communion. We had almost 150 young people receiving confirmation. Our school is at full capacity from TK through 8. All of them teaching this idea of being a Christian leader, of being the one who is not afraid of the wolves that are out there, but has that inner strength that can only come from our Lord. You know, we get that great, great strength, we get that wisdom, we get that power by calling on the Lord to be with us. So this gospel invites us to take up the mantle of leadership and to lead others to always respect all people, no matter who they are, that all people will always find that peace and joy that comes only in the kingdom of God. And God bless. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, and through him all things were made. For us and our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified and has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Dearly beloved, how great is the love we share as God's children. Placing our confidence in that love, we bring our prayers to the Father of Jesus and our Father. We ask for the salvation that God promises us in the risen Son.
For the people of St. Bruno Parish, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who shepherd the Holy Church of God will find courage in the name of Jesus Christ to share the healing Spirit of God with all people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the promise to protect candle calls us to continue diligence, watchfulness, and prayer for protecting children and young people from abuse. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in the name of Jesus Christ, those who suffer from injury or sickness be healed, the hungry be satisfied, the stranger be welcomed, and the unborn be protected. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died will find eternal life in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own personal intentions, we pray in silence. For these, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, in the power of Jesus' name, we stand before you in fervent prayer. Grant us and all your children the salvation Christ won for us by his death and resurrection through Christ our Lord. Amen. We are now at the offertory of the Mass, offering the gifts of bread and wine that usually come down the aisle, symbolized coming from your homes, from your family, joined with the prayers of the faithful that we have just proclaimed, and the intentions of your financial gifts. All of them are brought to the altar to be joined to the person of Jesus as he offers himself to our Father in heaven. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and the work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you, and lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to praise you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise in eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. Even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, "Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest." You are indeed holy, O Lord, and the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And let us proclaim this mystery of our faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the clergy and religious. And remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And together with Jesus, let us pray to our Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. And Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always." And let us share that peace with each other. The Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. And behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever. And just a few announcements, and again, just to remind you that all daily masses will be in the church now, Monday through Friday. Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, Masses are at 6:30 a.m. here in the church. Tuesday and Thursday, they are at 8 a.m. also in the church. For the time being right now, we don't have Mass on Saturday, either in the morning or in the afternoon. We hope to have those soon, but not yet. So Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 6:30 in the church. Tuesday and Thursday, 8 a.m. in the church. I'm glad to welcome back our friends from Bethlehem. The Bethlehem Olivewood products will be here on sale on the church patio next Sunday, May 2nd. So even though Sunday Masses are in the picnic tables, the Olivewood products will be here on the church patio. The theology of the body virtual conference. This is a concept that Pope St. John Paul II developed on integrating our faith with human nature. That virtual conference will feature dozens of guest speakers and artists on how the theology of the body concept of Pope St. John Paul II applies to everyday life. This free conference will open at noon on April 30th and close at midnight, May 2nd. Please see the bulletin for the complete set of information and especially how to watch. For the week of April 26th and 30th, this coming week, our office will close at 5 p.m. due to vacations. So we're just gonna close 2 hours earlier at 5 p.m. Always on our Sunday patio, our Sunday parking lot, are script sales that greatly help St. Bruno's School. We hope that you'll take advantage of that, and God bless. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. This Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.